back to another video here on Commando Gaming and Battletech Battles. Today we are continuing our series on Mech Warrior 5.2 and modded series, and we are going to bring another co-op video into the mix. So let's get right into this.
All right. Just so everybody knows what's going on, Alex is going to take a fire starter, which
with my hot rod paint job.
Given him a hot rod paint job.
Oh, he changed the paint job for the Centurion.
He's just a hot rod of a pilot. We're taking a Jaggermech, the fire starter, Centurion, and a Trebuchet.
Trebuchet trash.
This is a raid mission on behalf of House Davion. So let's just jump right into this. Should load up any second now. Really recommend that everybody go to Nexus Mods and take a look at all the great mods that are available right now. I have... We have about 8 mods that are currently installed. We're on a raid mission here, so let everybody form up.
Okay, want me to scout ahead?
Sure, that's your job as a fire starter to go ahead and scout ahead. That's
okay.
A good plan.
No, my cords are tangled.
Let's take a look at the map here. So we've got a target that's dead ahead. Probably go for that one first.
Dead ahead. Oh, turret. Got it. I thought this thing had small lasers.
It's got a large laser and a bunch of medium lasers.
Could have sworn last time I played it and it had small lasers.
Nope, it's a pretty powerful fire starter. Because it's the K version, so... It can mount a large laser.
Got it.
Alright, don't get too far ahead.
Here, I got targets. You cover me.
Starter.
I got this one.
That's some good salvage.
I'm stuck with stuff.
Got that fire starter under control?
Yeah, I can do it.
Alright, good job there on that fire starter.
Thanks. Moving up. And as you can see, we have some changes to make the game a little bit more like what we were used to. Kind of like Mech Warrior now. Well,
yep.
Mech Warrior Online.
That's one of the... I have 9 mods currently installed on this game, and the best part is the mod support is so good on this game that the mods just kind of stack on top of each other without any conflicts or problems. Probably wait for the rest of us.
Okay.
Alright. We're coming up behind you. Go ahead.
Accelerate.
I got you covered. So like I said, we have about nine to ten mods currently installed. So many, I don't even know, but they all stack so perfectly that I don't have to worry about it. I really like the improved HUD mod.
Mm-hmm.
Much better. Everything you need visibly is on
the mod
display, and you can still actually see more of your environment than the before, because the old HUD had things blocking your field of view. Her flanking unit.
I know.
I don't even know why we bothered to come on this mission with you, Alex. You could have handled it by yourself.
Yeah, you probably got more kills than me. That's the good thing about lights, you can really just get in and get out. Except you're gonna wanna take out next. I might go into commander next game.
Our hero commander?
Yeah. Switch it up, this thing needs repairs anyway.
Cool.
Okay, so
that was a pretty smooth mission.
Mm-hmm.
I think we could have just let Alex handle that one by himself.
You could have just waited up for me at the expo.
It could have saved us some drop costs there.
Or I could have just gone by myself. Like, you guys could have gone for one while I was going for the other two.
Yeah, usually the missions aren't that easy. We probably need to move on to another territory. They're getting a little too easy.
Mm-hmm. Now that we got that Jaeger mech. And my hot rod fire starter. Speaking of which, I'm going to custom paint that commando. I don't like the paint job on that thing. Unless you have changed it since I last saw it. KPPC.
As you can see, the loading screen is a lot faster.
Okay, you got more kills than me. I got 10, you got 13. I got most vehicles. The trebuchet got the most mechs.
Well, we only have one mech, I think.
Yeah, I only have one mech.
Alright, so let's go. What I want to do is we want to go...
Wait, start repairs on the stuff first. There's so little, you could probably just do it in the conflict zone.
That's fine. We'll travel over here. Because I want to set up to this other area that has more difficult missions.
Yeah. Wait, what's the rating for ours?
Right now we're in 5 territory. We're going to 6.
Yeah, that would probably be best. You always want to go stay in areas like... 1 or 2 levels lower than you actually are until you have a good enough mechs to do that.
Well, sometimes you have to grind in lower levels just to get enough money and mechs before you advance to the next level.
AC-5 for sale and LRM-20 plus Artemis. Oh! I can see the stuff too before it just showed the parameters.
Alright, so let's see. Oh, we got a pilot. We definitely want to hire Captain Egan here. So we're going to hire Captain Egan. And who do we want to get rid of? Let's see. Probably Captain... No, we'll get rid of Captain Cochran. No, Captain Cochran's pretty good.
Freeman.
No, we can't get rid of Freeman.
Freeman.
Yeah, we'll get rid of this guy.
Wait, but he's the same level as Freeman.
Actually, yeah, let's... We have enough money. We don't need to get rid of a pilot. All right, so we got a grasshopper available.
Ooh, javelin.
Javelin.
I'm kidding.
We do have another Jagger mech here, which is kind of interesting.
It looks basically like yours.
Would be...
It's basically about what yours looks like after...
Wouldn't it be bad to have another Jagger mech?
It basically looks like what yours would after a mission.
But I think what I want to do first... Let's see how...
Oh, a commando! Oh, wait, no. This is the inventory.
Sell this locust.
Yeah,
that part.
Locust is pretty useless. Pretty useless.
And let's go into the inventory, see what we have that we don't want to keep.
Those garbage AC-10s. Oh, machine guns. Machine guns.
Yeah, that's not really going to help us very much.
Hey, but it's still something. Hey, $5,000 can always get you out of the hole.
Alright, that's not going to help us very much. So, let's see. Let's look at the star map here.
Reputation
is
really not as important in this one as it is in Battletech.
Alright, so it's not telling me that there's any... Better, there's no heroes or rare mechs available, so I'm actually inclined to add that Jagger mech, actually. It'd be nice to have an extra Jagger mech, and we're actually doing pretty good money-wise right now.
You say that, then we'll go broke. Actually, I'd get the Hunchback just for that AC-20.
Yeah.
And it's a decent medium.
We already have a Hunchback, so...
We do?
Yeah, we do. So
since when?
Since a couple episodes ago.
Oh, right, I remember now. Speaking of which, can I paint that commando now?
We could probably do that off camera. What are you going to do? Do the hot rod?
Yeah, I was thinking about doing something different, actually. Actually, no, I could do the hot rod.
We just got a whole bunch of minor repairs here. Nothing too serious. Except for this Jagger mech. So let's see what we have that we can put on this Jagger mech here. Alright, so I think we could do...
What would be the most useful hero mech to find right now? In your opinion.
I'm not sure what you mean.
Like, right now, what would be the most useful hero mech that... If you could afford any hero mech, what would be the most useful right now?
Probably the K9...
Irby,
because it has all those... It's a really
and
cheap
also,
price, and it has a lot of good stuff in it.
And also, tell them about the little glitch that you found.
Well, there is a way that you can kind of buy and sell your mech, and I actually showed it on a previous video, where you can buy and sell the same mech over and over and over again. So that's a nice way to make the most out of your
and when you buy
situation.
It, you can strip it of everything and then you can sell it and it'd be fully restocked.
Yes, that is true. Alright, so... this is going to be really light on...
Oh no, that thing's going to be really light on armor.
Yeah, so we're going to do... We're going to take off the AC2s.
And then use max armor.
Upgrade the AC5BF. Increase the ammo.
Now max armor.
We're not quite done. So what we can also
do... Oh, heat tanks.
Yeah, we're going to do that. But first...
How are you already down to 2 double heat tanks?
Because I've been putting them on the mechs that we have. We're going to put machine guns on this guy.
That's actually a nice way to do. And, I don't know if this is smart. Actually, probably not. Yeah, put it there. How much ammo does one machine gun have ammo? 2,600. Yeah, I don't think you're running out anytime soon.
Alright, that should be enough.
What would be really good? A mech with almost no armor, but the ability to kill a medium in one alpha strike, but has, like, no armor. Or a mech that's basically can be ganged up on by, like, 4 atlases at the same time and survive for quite a while, but nothing but a machine gun, like a maximum tier machine gun, and, like, 10,000 rounds of ammo.
Alright, so that Jagger mech will be ready in 49 days. So, let's find us a mission, right?
Yep.
Okay.
Just not answer my question, because no one ever does. Okay. I'm kidding.
You can't have a mech that only has armor, because it'll eventually lose. Armor...
No, it has a lot of armor, but all it has is a machine gun.
It would get trashed very quickly. Let's do this high reward quest.
Mm.
How's that sound?
Color me intrigued.
Yeah, the high reward quests are the best ways. They kind of have a story to them, and they also let you progress a little bit faster than just if you were doing regular missions. So, we're 29 days away from getting our... Okay. Alright, so this is a mission where you're basically acting as a decoy. We'll get some single heat sinks.
Wait, if you can only get so much salvage, what happens to the rest of the salvage that you don't collect? I just thought that.
It stays with the house that you contract it with.
Oh.
Alright, so we have a Warzone mission, which is great, because we have a lot of fun with these Warzone missions.
Especially since I can just run circles around things.
So, let's...
I max out salvage, definitely.
Max out salvage...
take one out of the salvage and put it into damage.
That's okay. We'll be fine.
And we'll be able to pay for any damages in salvage.
Alright.
I will take...
So this is a level 36 mission, so this is a lot higher than what we've been doing.
The Commandant Commando.
Wait, so I think you should take the Archer. We need a lot of firepower on this one.
Then we got the Trippy Trash. How about just put the Archer in instead of the Trippy Trash?
We're going to take 2 Shadowhawks, an Archer, and a Jagger. That should be a pretty good loadout.
Wait, what else is available that would be better for me? Actually, I think I should go on the catapult.
Catapult only has missiles, that's it.
I know, I'll just walk backwards. Oh, and also, look at the paint job I put for it.
Okay, you can take the catapult if that's what you want to do.
Okay.
Alright, so we'll just let that load up.
I'm going on a quick bio break. I'll be right back.
Okay, you do that. Okay, we're just waiting for the game to load up here. The quest missions sometimes take a little longer. Quite. It's taking a little longer than it normally does. There's a couple tricks we could do there. Sometimes if you go to the home screen and you confirm the lance, it'll move things a little quicker.
I think you're the one that's stuck.
Game would load up. I'm not quite sure what challenge we're having here. Like I said, sometimes you have to just move around and click on a couple things, look at the
contract.
How
about you go to operations or something? And then go back? Back? Oh, there's an Irby on the market. Still nothing.
Let's see. Sometimes if we make a change to the mechs, that works. Something was stuck on the loading screen. Apologize for that. Shouldn't take us too much longer. One thing we should say, and you've probably seen from previous videos, that the Warzone missions, which we're about to do, are a lot more fun with the
mods that we have installed.
With the Better Spawn mod, which you can find at
Nexus Mods. Not sponsored.
And basically, that keeps the enemy from just dropping right on top of you every time, which makes...
It makes them drop at a minimum of, what, 500 meters away?
Usually around 200 meters. So far enough away that you can actually use all of your weapons. So
LRMs and stuff.
You can use your LRMs.
Which is very useful for me. Actually, what we can do is a triangle of protection, you and the lance can surround around me taking shots at whatever comes close, and I'll be in the center firing missiles at whatever is before out of your range.
Okay. Well,
and then by the time it comes in your range, it has no armor.
I'll try to make that happen for you, but we don't have so much control over the AI. But we'll
yeah,
do the
not
best.
As much as we'd like.
Right.
What are the weapons on these things?
Well, it finishes loading. We can take a quick look at this catapult. It does not have any weapons, any missiles, lasers on it, but it does have LRM 40. So Alex is going to have to play this very
and a pretty good paint
carefully.
Job. Right?
I've seen better.
Oh, no, you did not.
I like the paint jobs on mine.
What about the paint job on your Centurion? The pink? The all pink? Or did you change that?
Yeah, that's changed. Alright, we're ready to launch at last. Alright, so
I haven't hit ready yet.
We're definitely stepping up on difficulty here, so...
Wait, what was the difficulty for
level
35?
36.
No, now for the mission earlier?
17.
Yeah, we're kind of stepping up. I don't know if we're going to be able to use the lights very much anymore.
Maybe not.
But I still will try for some of the easier missions where speed is absolutely necessary. And also, it's always best to have one or two lights as a backup. Just in case you need to get in and out quickly, as I just said. Okay, moving.
Get in there and trigger it.
Oh, we don't have to take any enemies out before.
Doesn't look like it. So, the rest of the mechs don't have a lot of missiles, so make sure you're taking out those VTOLs for us.
I got 1,700. I got enough for everybody. And a little bit of extra. I really want to shoot the spire in the center just to see what would happen. Dropping two vehicles and maybe more. Two mechs.
Two vehicles and...
Locust and a javelin. Okay, those things are an actual problem for me.
That's why you gotta back off and let us handle.
One is down.
I got the other one.
Okay. You need help with that javelin? Too bad. Here's some. Here comes some. Watch out. We need to get streak for this. Need help with that scorpion over there? Okay.
Nope.
Where are they? Oh, they're actually right on the other side of this wall right here. Backing up. Oh.
Pull back.
Cicada. Moving to your six, Commander. Shredding the cicada now.
There's no reason we can't engage it long.
Oh,
later.
There's another one dropping. Oh, another vehicle. Uh-oh, Panther. Panther's hitting me.
Not so long.
Yeah, can you handle that, Panther? I'll work on the cicada. Okay, you know what? Oh, wrong way.
Out the Panther's PPC.
Okay, I got some of it. Okay, it's pretty much dead now. Harasser.
Go to the top of the hill. I see him. Go to the top of the hill.
On this, the hill that you're going to?
Yep.
Okay. Medium, cicada, shelling from the distance.
Yeah, engage with your missiles.
That's all I have to engage with. More dropping.
Got another one. Alright, turn to engage. That's room carrier down.
Cicada being shelled.
are down. I'm having the rest of the lance focus on the spider.
Speaking of cicada, it's inside my minimum range. Locust.
I can't engage everything. Alright, everybody's going after the locust now. Coming to the top of the hill.
Dropping. Looks like a vehicle. And okay, two mediums. Wolverine and a Vindicator. I got Vindicator. Wolverine first. And a cicada. Okay, I've lost sights on the Wolverine. Vindicator sighted. Oh, they're going around left side.
Focus on the Wolverine.
Shelling it. Okay, I almost took out a leg on the Wolverine. Okay, it's lost an arm and a leg. And almost the other leg. Come on. Okay, it's dead. I'm also shutting down. Incoming missiles. Okay, I'm shut down. Please tell me I killed it. Please get that cicada. I need to cool. I kind of need credit. Oh, look who lost an AC-10. You need help over there?
No, we're fine.
Doesn't look like it. Oh my god! Okay, that was perfect timing. I have 200
witnesses. Alright, head for the evac. Head for the evac.
Head in. I'm sure Jessup's Avengers will think twice before running a raid on what they think is a harmless supply convoy. I have 200 rounds left, so this is not going to be able to sustain heavy amounts of fire for very long.
Head for the evac.
Head in. Why I say put more ammo on this thing. Armor is actually really good. Oh, and we're also getting additional payout.
Not enough to stick around. We got some damage to deal with.
I noticed. Yeah, might as well fire off most of my missiles now. Got a helicopter down. Okay. So, that could have gone better.
We're fine.
Coming from the person missing an AC-10.
No big deal.
Okay.
No big deal. Mechs are supposed to get damaged. That's part of the game.
So what did we learn from that about your mech?
Nothing.
What I learned about from my mech, it has a decent amount of ammo, but it's not able to sustain a high volume of firepower for very long. Heat is not really an issue. I only overheated once.
Okay, that's good feedback, probably because it has double heat sinks.
Yeah, the ammo is where it's lacking. It's a LRM-20, so it goes through it really quick. And also, there it is. Okay, I've got a javelin and a locust. And a decent medium laser.
Alright, that's pretty good.
Okay, I got 5 kills, 2 mechs, 1 vehicle, and 2 airs. You got 5 vehicles and 2 mechs. And the Shadowhawk got the most kills, but lost the most.
Okay, so you probably have enough.
Yeah, I barely have anything.
Yeah, we can repair you.
So we can go straight to another mission.
That's about all we can repair.
We also have the Locust in cold.
Yeah.
A 1E.
So we got our next mission. Fortunately, we're gonna have our other Gregory Mech available now.
So we can give this one a rest.
Mine needs repairs.
So. Yeah, so it can have a rest without getting arrested.
Salvage here. Alright, we're gonna switch out that Jagger Mech for our other Jagger Mech. Okay. You are fine. Do you want to go in the catapult again?
What's the difficulty? 36 again? Yeah, I'm fine in the catapult. Wait, what is the game mode? Warzone. Yeah, I'll keep the catapult.
We're also gonna take an archer.
So we have double
and
use in
that. A hunchback.
Is this the new Jagger Mech?
Yep.
That you're in? Okay, so we can kind of see how it fares.
Alright, so a couple things I
need
to do real
quick. Actually, you know
what?
I'm gonna take the commando.
No.
I'm kidding.
Right, so one thing I learned is if the AI is taking a missile boat, you want to make sure that missiles are on one.
Why?
Because it's more likely to use its missiles that way. True story.
Okay.
Alright, so then one more thing. I got to adjust my loadout for Jagger Mech here.
That actually seems really good. Except I'd put machine guns on 3.
There we go.
Everything on 1?
Yep.
Okay.
It'll be fine. I'm not going to be using it too much. Most of it's going to be AC5s. I should have put those better medium lasers on it, but that's okay.
Or medium pulses. Medium pulses aren't really as good in this game as they are in others.
It's a lot of tonnage that you have to give up to have medium pulses, so.
Yeah, and medium
you have to
pulses,
have a really big mech with plenty of tonnage available to really do.
Yeah, medium pulses don't really do anything either. How much more damage do they do? Like 0.4 more damage? I'd rather do that and have 2 medium lasers than 1. Actually, how many turns is a medium pulse?
2.
Yeah, I can have 2 medium lasers, which would add up to more firepower than 1 medium pulse.
Yeah, usually medium pulses work out if you have big enough mechs that they have the tonnage to waste. Alright, almost done loading up here. Are we ready?
Yep.
Alright, so this is going to be a war zone again. Hopefully the catapult and the archer can give the hunchback and myself enough support that we can win through this.
You know I can give decent fire support. It's the archer that we gotta worry about.
It's pretty good. When, as long as you have the weapons on one, the missiles on one, he'll at least
use it a bit.
Use it. Use the LRMs as much as it can. It doesn't back off as much as I would like. All right, so we're in a hot environment.
Warriors have intentionally leaked some coordinates out across this region, pretending that the large unguarded shipment is going to be coming through. The hope is that any pirates looking for a score will head to the location where you will lay in wait.
So it's basically a scam.
Oh, they're on the other side of the hill here. All right, follow me.
Following.
They're on the top of the hill. They have an advantage, so we gotta move. So I have to come down.
Actually,
to the bottom.
No, we've got an advantage. If they back up, we can't hit them, but neither can.
VTOLs, VTOLs, VTOLs.
Where? Behind us.
In
my room, rage, can't do anything.
Right. Come over here.
Got it.
Alright, we're gonna set up over here on this hill. And they will have to come to us.
Oh, behind us! Behind us!
Yes, I know.
Javelin and a spider.
Use those missiles. To land in front of us now. We're at the edge of the map.
We are?
There,
oh, yeah, we
there
are.
Must be another enemy vehicle. So let's move forward carefully. There, it's a harasser. It's way far away.
Here, I'll get to it.
I must have got stuck on.
Hey, don't forget to use night vision.
I don't like the night vision too much.
And it's not as good as it is in the Mech Warrior.
Let's take out this last vehicle, and then we can actually take the high ground ourselves up here.
Mm-hmm.
Since we're in Warzone, we can dictate where we fight, because we don't have to protect anything, we don't have to stay in a particular area.
As soon as
area.
I get up to the top of the hill, I'll be able to
hit. Yeah, why don't you save your missiles?
You sure?
Yeah. Save your missiles.
Okay.
Where is he?
He should be at the bottom of this valley. He has to. We're reaching the edge of the map. There he is. He fell through the ground.
That's a problem.
Yeah.
Through
can get exactly to him on the mini map. He's like right up here.
Alright, this is kind of a glitch.
He's about right where he was. Oh, he's moving. Right here.
All these volcanoes are so cool.
I wish there would just be like a set time limit instead of this.
Well, we got a problem if we can't get this guy.
He's falling deeper. Yeah, he's no longer visible. Here, let me get far enough away so maybe I can fire a missile.
He's stuck in the ground. Hoping he'd get out. Or I've had this happen before, and then you just shoot the spot and they get destroyed.
Usually that's when they're flipped upside down, but we can't really shoot because we're not in lights. He is so far down there. Third person, you can kind of see him a bit easier.
Always get this nagging feeling that I'm gonna be blasted into space when near volcanoes like this.
Alright, well, I think what we need to do here is we need to end the video.
I saw your machine guns coming right at me. Maybe.
Nope, we're gonna have to end this video and then we'll try picking this up on the next video with a reset. Because the enemy... This happens sometimes, so we'll just not worry about it. And we'll see you on the next video of Commando Gaming and BattleTech Battles. So please subscribe to our channels and hit the like button. And we'll talk to you soon.